Hi students, welcome back to Advanced English class. Today's lesson is the here and now. This is related to prepositions. So what is preposition means? Words that are used to describe position of a noun, that means a person, object or place, are called prepositions. They are usually placed before a noun in a sentence. So here is one picture. So by observing the picture, we have to do what they are doing. We have to write what they are doing. For example, the man on the left has two bags in his hand. In the same manner, where different people are, we have to explain. See clearly, there are vegetables and fruits on the cart. There are vegetables in the basket on a man's head. There are fruits and vegetables in the basket. A vegetable vendor is passing by the cart. A woman is holding a handbag in her hand. A woman and a child are standing beside the cart. Okay, till now you have talked about the position of people and things in relation to other people or things in the picture. Now listen to the passage that will read out by your teacher to learn more words that denote such relations. Okay, so the question is, what is this paragraph about? And next one is, where is the playground? What is opposite the college? Where is the statue of the donor? Where do the students sit during lunch hour? So here I read the paragraph. Our college is situated between the government hospital and Rotary auditorium. Behind our college, there is a big playground. Students play there cricket. Beside our college, there is a photo studio. Opposite our college, there is a departmental store where students buy books, pencils and other stationery items. There is a canteen in our college. You can find a statue of the founder installed at the entrance of our college. Our college looks very green because there are many trees in the campus. There are a few cement benches under the trees. Students sit on these benches during lunch hour. So the main content summary of this paragraph is, it is about the college surroundings area. Next, where is the playground? The playground is behind the college. Next, what is opposite the college? There is a departmental store opposite to the college. Where is the statue of the donor? That means founder. The statue of the donor is installed at the entrance of the college. Next, where do the students sit during lunch hour? The students sit on the benches that are placed under the trees. Next, we have to identify the prepositions which shows the position of the objects, persons, things, etc. So between, it shows the position of the college and government hospital and Rotary auditorium. So between, behind means venaka, beside prakkana, opposite eduruga, at vadda, in low, under kinda, on meeda, in that way. Next, so what are such words are called? These words are prepositions of position. Next, one more lyric. Here is lyric. So what is this lyric about? And identify the page of words that with similar end sounds, ambition, position, like. And next, what does the speaker questions, you have to answer the questions. What does the speaker want preposition to tell? Where could the speaker be sitting? Where does the speaker want to take a walk? Among whom does the speaker want to be? Okay, right. Now the lyric. Preposition, it is your ambition. To tell me exactly my position. I could be on the coach or outside my house. Am I across the street or within your reach? Did I go up the stairs or fall off my chair? Am I in front of you or you behind me too? Prepositions, it is your ambition to tell me exactly my position. Preposition, you are on a mission to tell me exactly my position. Now take a walk with me and we will go by the sea and then along the path that goes around and back and underneath the waves or inside a cave, and before we are through we will jump over the moon. Now I am about to say, without further delay, when you are next to me, that is where I want to be. Now we are near the end, but we are among good friends. So then after this line, we will do it one more time. Preposition, it is your ambition to tell me exactly my position. So what is this lyric about? It is about prepositions. Am I right? Next. What does the speaker want preposition to tell? The speaker wants preposition to tell the exact position of an object. Next. Where could the speaker be sitting? The speaker could be sitting on the coach. Next, where does the speaker want to take a walk? The speaker wants to take a walk to the sea. Next, among whom does the speaker want to be? The speaker wants to be among good friends. Next, state what the song is about. About prepositions. Okay, rhyming words, stayed, chair, mission, position. Say delay. Okay, next we have to identify the prepositions in this lyric. Okay, we have to list out all the prepositions given in the lyric. On, outside, across, within, up, front, fall off, behind, with, by, along, around, underneath, back, inside, before, over, next, near, end, among, after, like that. Okay, right. Next, here are the explanation of the prepositions of position with examples. Between, preposition between. Between meaning is in the middle of the two, rendu vyaktulu, and iddaru vyaktulu rendu vastula madhya, kevalam rendu vastulu iddaru vyaktulu matrame, alanta appudu matrame between word. The example, the boy is standing between his parents are two, the house is between the trees, and ikkada only two trees. Okay, the house is between the trees. Next, among means in the midst of more than two, or surrounded by more than two. Rendu kante ekko chuttu undadam, rendu kante ekko undadam. Among ante kevalam rendu. Between ante kevalam rendu. Among means rendu kante ekko. Example of among is the house is among the trees. That means more than two trees are there. See the picture. Next, behind means backside, venaka. See the picture, there is a tree behind the house. Next, important one, beside means by the side of, and prakkana. There is a tree beside the house. But here, very important point is besides, one more word is there, besides. Besides means along with and danto patuga, additional. I speak English besides Telugu. And English matlaadtanu danto pat Telugu kuda. But beside means by the side of prakkana. Besides ante danto patuga. Next, in front of. In front of means front side, mundu. There is a tree in front of the house. Picture lo chudan. Then opposite anna kuda front side. Opposite means front side. But the other side of the road. Road ki avatal pakkana. Chudan picture lo. There are two houses opposite each other. Next, in, at, on, very important. In says about the place covered by all sides, at least three sides. At least moodu vaipula moosiveyabadi unnatuvanti pradesham. Are surrounded, covered by vast area. The cat is sleeping in the corner. Where are you? I am in the classroom. So classroom is surrounded by the walls, closed by the walls. It means nearby, daggaralo, somewhere around, akkada. The man is standing at the corner. A moola daggara nivadadu. Next, on. On means on in contact with. And kachitanga adi contact lo undadu, touch ayi undadu. The cat is on the house. Here, one more explanation. In, at, difference. When the place is small, we have to use at. When the place is big, we have to use in. Suppose in comparing with Hyderabad and Nalgonda, which one is big? Hyderabad is big. Then we have to use in. And the Nalgonda city, small. So we have to use at. When you compare to Nalgonda and VT colony, VT colony is smaller than Nalgonda town. So we have to use in Nalgonda at VT colony. When you compare to a Ganesh stationery shop, it is located in VT colony. So VT colony and Ganesh station shop. VT colony is bigger than Ganesh station shop. So we have to use in VT colony at Ganesh station shop. Chinna vatiki at pedda vatiki in. That is the difference. Right. I hope you understood well. Next. Here is one map. We have to explain the position of the mentioned place. Okay. Here is main road, bank, parking area, temple kitchen, temple, store, workers, changing room, temple office, shopping complex, cinema, restaurant, tea stall, florist, clock room, museum, park, bus complex, queue complex, lodge, common toilets, barber's place, lodge, staff quarters, like that. So suppose if I ask you, where is the shopping complex? Shopping complex is, we have to write like this, shopping complex is opposite to tea stall because there is a road. Where is the cinema? The cinema is between shopping complex and the restaurant. Okay. Where is the temple? The temple is between parking area and temple office. In that manner, you have to explain the position of these places. Okay. Next activity. Here is given below are a few prepositions and their meanings. Make sentences using them with the help of the picture. ఈ పిక్చర్లో ఇచ్చినటువంటి పొజిషన్స్ని ప్లేసెస్ని ప్రిపోజిషన్స్ బేస్ చేసుకొని మనం ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ ఇవ్వడం మీనింగ్ ఇవ్వడం జరిగింది విత్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వీ హావ్ టు రైట్ అబౌ ఓవర్ బై బిసైడ్ ఆన్ టాప్ ఆఫ్ దట్ మీన్స్ అబౌ ఓవర్ మీన్స్ ఆన్ టాప్ ఆఫ్ Next, behind, in front of, under, beneath, below. under or underneath. So by, beside, both express the position, same meaning. By the side of, by ante prakkana, beside ante prakkana, besides ante dantho paatu. A man is standing by the car. Car prakkana nilabaddadu, nilabaddadu chunnadu. Next, at means near, surrounding area, somewhere near. So suppose if you say a man is standing at the car daggara nilabaddadu. On means you know, in contact, kastanga contact ayi undali, touch ayi undali. Suppose so where is the mobile? On the table, like that. Next, in here, covered by all sides, at least three, minimum three, leda big area. So if you take example, two children are sitting in the car, like that. Under means downside, kinda, but exactly vertical position, kachitanga kindane undali. Suppose table anukondi, table kinda manam oka book pettam anukondi, aa book ekkada untadi, exact ga table kindane untadu anamata. Alaga ante aa book iskelli kinda pettam, ante aa floor meeda, on the floor meeda pettam, but not under the, ante kachitanga table kinda pettaledu. టేబుల్ పై కంటే, టేబుల్ కంటే కిందికే ఉంది, కానీ ఎగ్జాక్ట్ టేబుల్ కింద లేదు. అలాంటప్పుడు అది వెర్టికల్ పొజిషన్ కాదు, అది బిలో అంటారు. సో అండర్ మీన్స్ డౌన్ సైడ్, ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ వర్టికల్ పొజిషన్. అలా చూసుకుంటే మనం ఎగ్జాంపుల్గా, దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ డ్రైనేజ్ మ్యాన్ హోల్ అండర్ ద కార్. ఈ కార్ కింద, కార్ కింద మ్యాన్ హోల్ ఉందన్నమాట. దర్ ఈజ్ ఏ డ్రైనేజ్ మ్యాన్ హోల్ అండర్ ద కార్. నెక్స్ట్ ఓవర్. ఓవర్ మీన్స్ అప్ సైడ్, పైన, ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ వర్టికల్ పొజిషన్. సపోజ్ దర్ ఈజ్ ఏ ఫ్యాన్ ఓవర్ మై హెడ్. సపోజ్ దర్ ఈజ్ ట్యూబ్లైట్ అనేది పక్కకు దూరంగా ఉంది, పైనే ఉంది బట్ దూరంగా ఉంది. దెన్ వీ సే అబోవ్ అంటాం, దాన్ని దూరంగా ఉంది, పైన ఉంది బట్ దూరంగా ఉంది అంటే అబోవ్ అంటాం. డిఫరెంట్ లెవెల్, ఎగ్జాక్ట్గా ఉంటే అది ఓవర్. సో ఎగ్జాంపుల్, ఏ కట్ కేబుల్ వైర్ ఈజ్ హ్యాంగింగ్ ఓవర్ ద కార్. ఈ కార్ మీదుగా ఒక కేబుల్ వేలాడుతూ ఉంది అంటున్నాం. నెక్స్ట్ బిలో, డౌన్ సైడ్, కింద, కానీ డిఫరెంట్ లెవెల్ పొజిషన్లో అనమాట. దెర్ ఈజ్ ఏ సెస్ పూల్ బిలో ద రోడ్ సైడ్. నెక్స్ట్ అబోవ్, అప్ సైడ్, పైన. ఏ సైన్ బోర్డ్ ఈజ్ షోయింగ్ నో పార్కింగ్ ఈజ్ అబోవ్ ద కార్. ఇక్కడ ఎవరిని నాకేం కనపడలేదు సార్, మీకేం కనిపిస్తున్నాయని మీరు అనొద్దు. జస్ట్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. Next, B. Here are two pictures. In these two pictures, some items are there. Where are the items? Where are the things? We have to say using the prepositions of position. The chair is pushed under the table. See, this chair is pushed under the table. The clock is kept on the books. Here, in the first picture, the clock is kept on the books. The books are arranged in the shelf. Next, the guitar is hanging between two photos on the wall. Okay. Next, shoes are lying on the floor. Yes, here also. Next, chappals are lying on the floor. The photo of goddess is hanging on the wall. There is a mat lying on the floor. A pillow is kept on the mat. There are many books lying on the table. Right. Next, listen to another passage that your teacher will read out. State what it is about. and also answer the questions. Where does Sarala's brother work? When does he not work? On what day and at what time does the review session start? Okay. My brother is now with a software firm. Now with a software firm means he is working in a software company. Every day his work starts at 10 a.m. and goes on till 7 o'clock in the evening. The team leads, that means team leaders, are supposed to submit their reports by 1 p.m. on every Monday. Usually, they do not work on Sundays. Everybody attends the review sessions on Fridays from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. Here, have you observed the change? Previously, we talked about the prepositions of position. Now, the prepositions mentioned in this paragraph are all related to time. Okay, good. Now, what is this paragraph about? The passage is about daily routine at workplace of Sarala's brother's work. Okay, right. Next questions. Where does Sarala's brother work? Sarala's brother works in a software firm. When does he not work? He does not work on Sundays. On what day and at what time does the review session start? The review session runs on Fridays between 3 to 5 p.m. Right. Now, next question. Read the passage once again and list out the words that state the relationship of time. Example, at. So, at, on, till, in the evening, this is also in the evening, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, and at night. I hope you all know this. Morning session, we say in the morning. Afternoon session, in the afternoon. Evening session, in the evening. But night, at night. Right. Supposed to submit their reports by 1 p.m. By 1 p.m. means not exactly 1 p.m. Before 1 p.m. The work should be done before 1 p.m. And ఒకటి కంటే ముందే, suppose by Monday అంటే Monday రోజు కాదు, Monday కంటే ముందే, Sunday or Friday, Saturday, whatever it may be. On every Monday, on next, on Sundays, on Fridays, from to. Okay. Next. We have the explanation of what is at, what is by, because in the position, prepositions of positions, we learnt in, at, on. The same prepositions come in prepositions of time also. What about at? At shows exactly specific time, exact time. That means at 8 o'clock, at 3:30 p.m. in that manner. By means, in position, by means pakkana. Ikkada before. That means by 8 o'clock means 8 kante munde. 8 gantlaku munde. By 3:30 p.m. ante 3:30 p.m. ki munde. By Monday ante somaraniki munde. Next, till, until, both same. Up to a specific time. Kachitamaina samayamu. Up to a specific time. Until 7 o'clock. And appadi varaku. Suppose my class ends at 2 p.m. And my class continues up to 2 p.m. My class continues up to until I will take the class until 2 p.m. I will continue the class till 2 p.m. Until till and varaku. At a certain time varaku. Till the class is over. You have to be online. You have to listen the class. Until the class is over. Until the class is over. Next, on. Intakumundu on ante position lo in contact with antunna. Ikkada on is used with dates. One, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, whatever it may be, up to 31st. Dates. Name of the days. You know, name of the days, 7 days are there. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. All days take preposition on. On Sunday, on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Thursday, on Friday. Like that. on Tuesday, on Sunday, on 13th of March. Next, from to, that means from is time of beginning, to is time of ending. Suppose my class begins, I will take class from 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. I will take class from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. in that manner. From shows the beginning time, to shows the ending time. Right. In the same manner, between and. Between and. Time, between shows the time of beginning and shows the time of ending. Between 6 a.m. and 7 a.m. like that. Next, during. During and a kalam lo. That means during summer holidays, during COVID lockdown. Like that. During those days. And between certain time, duration. Next, after. After means taravata. At a later time. After the class. You will do whatever you like. But after the class only. Like that. After 6 o'clock. Next, for. For anedi total duration. Since for both are important. Duration, if the duration shows, we have to use for. Point of time shows, we have to use since. For 2 hours, for a year, for a moment, like that. Since means since 8 April, since yesterday, since my childhood, since 6 o'clock, in that manner. Next, activity 6. You have to say, on what day were you born? Suppose you are born on Friday. You have to say on Friday. You have to write here. I was born on Friday. On what date were you born? Suppose you are born on 10th May. Suppose 10th. On 10th. At what time were you born? Maybe I suppose you are born on 2 o'clock. 2 p.m. At 2 p.m. Next, in which month were you born? Suppose you were born in May. In May. I was born in May. In which year you were born? Suppose you were born in 2004. I was born in 2004. In that manner. You are right. Next, when do you leave home to go to college? Suppose you are staying in a hostel, I suppose. Your college starts is 9:30. Then, when do you leave home or hostel to go college? I leave hostel at 9:15 a.m. Next, at what time do you reach college? By 9:30. I reach college by 9:30. 9:30 varakala, 9:30 munde. Next, when do you have your lunch break? From 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock. Next, when do you do homework? After 5 o'clock. I do homework after 5 o'clock. When do you relax? After 7 o'clock. I relax after 7 o'clock. I relax after 8 o'clock. In that manner. Next, listen to another passage that your teacher will read. State what it is about. And also answer the questions. When did you go to the zoo? What was very exciting? What was the lion doing? In that manner. Okay. Next. We went to the zoo on Sunday. We took a bus from our house to the zoo. In the zoo, we boarded a train that passed through the tunnel. At a tunnel. This was very exciting. After we got down from the train, we walked towards the enclosures of the wild animals. There we saw a lion climbing onto a rock. What a sight it was. Next, tell me, what is this paragraph about? Visit a zoo. Okay, next. When did you go to the zoo? I went to the zoo on Sunday. Next, what was very exciting? Boarding a train that passed through a tunnel was very exciting. Next, what was the lion doing? The lion was climbing onto a rock. Okay, what are the next? Read the passage once again and list out words that show sense of direction.
Yeah.
See, in the beginning we have learned prepositions of position. In next, prepositions of time. Now, prepositions of moment, sense of direction. This is third point. Okay. Sense of direction words. So, we went through the zoo. Zoo ki vellamu. Passed through a tunnel. So, tunnel gunda vellindi. Next, down. After we got down. Kindiki digina tarvata. Next, from the train. Train nundi. Towards vaipu. Onto meediki. In that manner. Okay. Now explanation, clear explanation. Into means innu into difference endante in means lopala, that is the position, that is the position. Into means movement. Into anedemo movement, in anedemo position. You are in the class, suddenly one boy came into the class, and by outside to inside, byte nunchi lopalku vachadu, that is the movement, that is into. You are already in the class. So, class lo kuchunana, sir, nenu atu itu tirugutunanu, sir, nenu. Okay, you are moving. But you are still in the classroom. So, you have to say in the classroom only. Okay, outside to inside means into. Next, suppose you are going outside. That is inside to outside. Then you have to use out of. So, into means the... She poured coffee into the cup. The teacher is going into the classroom. Next, outside means the teacher went out of the classroom. Next, through. Through one day, shoot in the picture. Lo. Dwara, gunda. So, moving along a covered area. The train went through the tunnel. Next, onto. Onto means from one place to the other place. Oka pradesham chi maro place ki. The cat jumped on the floor. Onto the floor. Cat em chestundante table meeda undi. Table meenchi nela meeda dookindi. The cat jumped onto the floor. Right. Now, here are some prepositions. To, at, into, onto, from, into, towards. See the picture and fill the blank. She is walking dash the house. See what is going on. She is walking towards vaipu. She is walking towards the house. She came to the house. Daggariki vachesindi. She is about to go inside the house. She is walking into the room. Right. He is looking dashes. He is looking at us. We are traveling dash New York dash Paris, from New York to Paris. The crab was, crab and entertaining, the crab was dash the shore. Washed, the crab washed onto the shore. Neat lo nunchi oddiki kottukochi. Next. The paper went dash the basket, into the basket, lopal kellindi. Inside, into the basket. Next. Ikkada additional information. By EU is used to refer to mode of transport or travel. Chala important and idi manamu suppose ekkadikanna traveling chesinappudu journey chesinappudu ela chesavu ela e vidhanga vellavu ante bus dwara vellava train dwara vellava car lo vellava bike meeda vellava nadchukunta vellava ila. So mode of transport. Generally, we use by and bus dwara, not by bus, train aithe by train, car aithe by car, air aithe, aeroplane aithe by air. Sometimes we use by bike or sometimes we use on bike. Okay, right. But we go on foot. Eppudaina nadusukuntu vellam anko. Nadusukuntu vellinappudu, we should not say by walk. We have to say on foot. On foot. So we go on foot and all. Ante gani. Itla antan sir. వి గో ఆన్ వాక్ అంటారు సార్ రైట్ అన్నారు నో వాక్ అని అనొద్దు ఆన్ ఫుట్ అన్నారు వి గో ఆన్ ఫుట్ నాట్ ఆన్ వాక్ నాట్ బై వాక్ రైట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఐ వెంట్ టు కాలేజ్ బై వాక్ రాంగ్ ఐ వెంట్ టు కాలేజ్ ఆన్ వాక్ రైట్ సార్ రాంగ్ ఐ వెంట్ టు కాలేజ్ ఆన్ ఫుట్ రైట్ నెక్స్ట్ హియర్ ఇస్ వన్ యాక్టివిటీ ఫిల్ ఇన్ ద బ్లాంక్స్ యూజింగ్ ద వర్డ్స్ గివెన్ ఇన్ ద బాక్స్ యూజ్ పిక్చర్స్ యాజ్ క్యూస్ క్యూస్ మీన్స్ హింట్స్ బస్ స్టాప్ డ్రైవ్ రీచ్ ఆఫీస్ గో బై టాక్సీ గో బై ట్రైన్ గో బై బస్ గో బై టూ వీలర్ లీవ్ హోమ్ వాక్ రైట్ సీ ద పిక్చర్ ఐ గో బై డాష్ ఇక్కడ ట్రైన్ చూపిస్తున్నాడు కాబట్టి ఐ గో బై ట్రైన్ అని చెప్పాలి ఐ గో బై ట్రైన్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ వాక్ డాష్ టు ద ఇక్కడ ఇదేంటిది ఇది ట్రైన్ వెళ్ళేది ట్రైన్ది ఏంటిది అది రైల్వే స్టేషన్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ వాక్ టు ద రైల్వే స్టేషన్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ వాక్ టు ద రైల్వే స్టేషన్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ 5 minutes ఫ్రమ్ మై హౌస్ ఓకే ఐ ఆల్వేస్ డాష్ ఐ ఆల్వేస్ లీవ్ హోమ్ ఎర్లీ నెక్స్ట్ ఐ యూజువల్లీ డాష్ ఇక్కడ కార్ ఉంది కాబట్టి మనం ఏమంటే ఐ యూజువల్లీ గో బై కార్ కార్ అంటే కారు లేదా ఇక్కడ టాక్సీ అని ఇచ్చింది కదా సార్ ఐ యూజువల్లీ గో బై టాక్సీ రైట్ ఐ యూజువల్లీ గో బై టాక్సీ బట్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఎ నైస్ డే వాతావరణం బాగుంటే ఏం చేస్తాను ఐ సమ్ టైమ్స్ డాష్ ఐ గో బై టూ వీలర్ ఐ డాష్ ఎట్ 10 అంటే ఐ లీవ్ హోమ్ ఎట్ 10 o'clock రీచ్ ఐ రీచ్ ఆఫీస్ అని కూడా అనొచ్చు ఇక్కడ ఏముంది మనకి లీవ్ హోమ్ ఉంది ఆఫీస్ ఉందా ఎస్ ఉంది ఇక్కడ ఐ రీచ్ హోమ్ ఎట్ 10 రైట్ నెక్స్ట్ ఐ యూజువల్లీ డాష్ ఇక్కడ బస్ ఉంది కాబట్టి ఐ యూజువల్లీ గో బై బస్ దెర్ ఈజ్ ఎ డాష్ జస్ట్ అవుట్ సైడ్ మై హౌస్ మా ఇంటి పక్కనే ఉంది ఏంటిది ఉంది బస్ స్టాప్ దెర్ ఈజ్ ఏ బస్ స్టాప్ జస్ట్ అవుట్ సైడ్ మై హౌస్ ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ లేట్ ఒకవేళ నేను లేట్ అయితే ఏం చేస్తాను ఐ సమ్ టైమ్స్ గో బై కార్ ఫినిష్ నెక్స్ట్ కామన్ ఎర్రర్స్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ హీ కేమ్ ఇన్ ద క్లాస్ హీ కేమ్ ఇన్ ద క్లాస్ అంటారా ఇన్ టు ద క్లాస్ అంటారు అవుట్ సైడ్ టు ఇన్సైడ్ నెక్స్ట్ he came by walk I already explained she came by walk wrong she came on foot he jumped on the horse ఇప్పుడు మూమెంట్ జంపింగ్ ఇట్లాంటి మూమెంట్ వచ్చినప్పుడు ఆన్ టు అపాన్ ఇలాంటివి వస్తాయి he jumped upon the horse ఇక్కడ ఏంటంటే హార్స్ అనేది లివింగ్ యానిమల్ లివింగ్ థింగ్ సో వీ హావ్ టు యూస్ అపాన్ నాట్ ఆన్ టు ఓకే దే ఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ పాలిటిక్స్ ఇది చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్ అండి దే ఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ పాలిటిక్స్ అన్నారు డిస్కస్ అనే వర్డ్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత అబౌట్ అనే ప్రిపరేషన్ కానీ ఏ ప్రిపరేషన్ కానీ రాయకూడదు దే ఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ పాలిటిక్స్ మై హౌస్ ఈజ్ బిసైడ్స్ ద థియేటర్ ఐ ఆల్రెడీ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఇన్ ద బిగినింగ్ బిసైడ్స్ ఈజ్ ఎలాంగ్ విత్ అనమాట దాంతో పాటుగా బిసైడ్ అంటే ప్రక్కన మై హౌస్ ఈజ్ బిసైడ్ ద థియేటర్ ఓకే అబ్జర్వ్ ద మీనింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రిపరేషన్స్ వైల్ రీడింగ్ use dictionary to learn which preposition goes with what word right so assignment the boy is standing dash girls seven girls are there one boy is there and the boy is standing among the girls right the girl is standing among the boys four boys are there the boy is standing between his mother and father right ikkada picture chudandi questions where are the trees the tree is behind the house okay the trees are behind the house where is the car The car is in front of the house. Where is the bus stop? The bus stop is opposite to the house. Where are the people? The people are in the bus stop. Next, what are the people are doing? They are waiting for the bus. They are waiting for the bus. They are about to board the bus. Right. Next, see. Where are the things? Watch. Where is the watch? The watch is on the table. Books. The books are on the table. Clothes. The clothes are hanging on the wall. Next, glasses. Glasses are on the table. Painting. The painting hanging on the wall. Next, flower vase. Flower vase on the stool. Right. So, assignment 4. Here some words are given. Prepositional verbs, phrasal verbs like that. Observed in, according to, accustomed to, afraid of, anxious about, ashamed of, aware of, exposed to, fit for, following, fond of, frightened of, frightened at, good at, good for, interested in, involved in, tired of, used to, pleased to, prepared for, like that. You have to write them in your notebook, write the meaning, and write one example sentence usage for all these. Okay, next, assignment 5. Write a paragraph using the cues given below. Use appropriate prepositions of place, time, and direction. 3 points are there. Three types of prepositions. Suppose here the situation is you went to cinema. Then how did you go there? When did you reach? How was the film? How did you return home? How did you return home? Like that, the questions are there. So when you left home, suppose first show movie, 6 o'clock movie, we suppose. When you left home, I left home at 5 o'clock. When you reached there, I reached the theater by 5:30. How you went there? I went by taxi. When you returned home, I reached my home by 9:30. How long you were there in the cinema hall? Nearly 3 hours. Say 5, 6 to 7, 8, 9. For 3 hours. Okay. Next, whether you had any snacks or soft drinks during interval? Yes. Who played the major role in the film? You can say your favorite. Okay. Right. Any other details you want? If you want to say, you can say. Right. Next, assignment. A few more words are there. Accused of, accuse of, apologize for. Right. You have to write the meanings in notebook. And write one example sentence also. Okay, this is the lesson of prepositions, the here and now. This is very long and lengthy lesson. Unit 2, this is unit 2. 5 marks questions, 3 marks questions, 1 mark questions all come from this lesson. Very important lesson. So listen once again, practice them, prepare well for the examinations. Write all the assignments, activities in your notebook. When you come to the class, online class, if you have any doubt, you can clarify them. Okay. With this, I am closing this session. Thank you very much. Bye.